Hello, hello, my beautiful souls, and welcome back to my channel. This is Sharon Knows Best, and today I have another Pick a Card Tarot reading for you guys, which I'm super excited about. Today I wanted to keep it fun and spicy, and we're just gonna see what will come up and what resonates with you guys. Today we're gonna focus on the question, what does your person sexually fantasize about with you guys? So we're gonna just roll into it, all spicy and kinky. We all love this energy. At least I know a lot of you guys enjoy these readings. That's why I wanted to do one of these today. So if you enjoyed this video, definitely make sure to like and subscribe. Comment down below, support, support, support. And yeah, so without further ado, let's just jump right into this reading. I have gathered here three crystals for your readings today. You just need to choose one crystal and then look down in the description box below which timestamp belongs to the crystal that you chose. And then you can just forward to your reading. And I've chosen three crystals today. The green crystal is gonna be pile number one, the blue crystal is gonna be pile number two, and the orange brownish crystal will be pile number three. As always, I will insert a clip of a close-up so you can take your time choosing the right reading for you guys. And also, you can always pause the video if you just wanna gather and see what your intuition says is the right reading for you. So let's have some fun and let's dive into your reading. All right. Pile number one, if you chose this green crystal, then this is your reading. So if you didn't know, this crystal represents the heart chakra. So green is the color of the heart. And yes, so what does your person fantasize about when they think about you? So this is a really interesting topic, so let's just dive right in. So I'm just trying to figure out, should I take my Sexual Magic Tarot deck or my Rider Waite? Okay, let's dive in and start with my normal tarot cards. This is so exciting! I haven't done one of these spicy readings in quite a while, and if you're wondering why I have this like new setup and new background going on, we're actually in my apartment. I moved out and this is my kitchen. So yeah, I wanted to keep the background really neutral. What does pile number one's person, may it be a crush, a relationship, or a random person, sexually fantasizes about when they think of them? Okay. Oh my goodness. Okay. Let's take this one. Let's put this back. So the first card that came out, and these are really reflective, so don't get irritated. So the first card that came out is the Two of Wands. The Two of Wands obviously represents fire energy, so passion. They might get hard really, really quickly when they think of you if we're talking about masculine energy. If we are talking about feminine energy or a woman, then this person, you know, might get wet really, really easily. And we're cutting right to the chase. Let me not get awkward. This person, when they think of you in a sexual way, I feel like they really fantasize about traveling with you and having, you know, some sexy time with you wherever in the world you might end up together. And this is really, really cute because I'm really getting that feeling that this person loves to spend time with you. Like, they just want to be with you, they want to travel with you, they want you by their side. And again, it doesn't matter if you're a guy or a woman, and gender really doesn't matter here. So just apply it to your situation. Doesn't matter if you're thinking about a guy or a woman, whatever your sexuality is, it doesn't matter. Just apply it to your situation. So I feel like this person, they just want you there and they want to travel with you and they want to do it outside. They want to what's really coming out is like having a good time with you in another country, because there's this globe here, and the Two of Wands for me always represents travel. And also, like, it's two, you know, so it's like two people. They don't want to travel in a group, they don't want to travel alone, they do want to travel with you together, like as a couple, or as, you know, two individuals just having some fun and traveling and discovering different places, and also happening to have sex in different places. The Page of Swords. For me, this card represents new energy. So this might be someone fairly new in your life. Maybe you've just met them. Maybe you've been friends for quite some time. I'm sorry. but this is fairly new. This gives me like really fresh energy. It could also represent a very young person that wants to conquer you, or that has these like sexual thoughts about you. They could be young, but it's funny because we have the Hierophant as well. This represents a more mature, caretaking, providing energy to me. And the Hierophant often also represents marriage. So apply to your situation. There might be some people in this reading that are quite young still, or just young, like mentally, a little like, you know, just freedom, and they're doing their thing. And then there might be other people here that are already more evolved in life. And either way, like, it doesn't matter, like, it's good energy either way. Just do your thing. I'm just saying there might be different scenarios here. So there might be people that are already married or in a really long-lasting commitment for a little while. And then there might be other people that are still kind of figuring out life as they're moving on. So this could represent your energy, or this could represent your person's energy. But for the most part, I'm feeling this person is still quite fairly new in your life. And I am getting the feeling this person wants to pursue you, but they do want to get to know you better. And I really feel like this person, I mean, what's a better way to get to know someone better than travel? Like, and travel doesn't mean like, we have to go to Thailand, we have to go to Australia, we have to do this and do that. This could literally be just a weekend trip close to your city or country or whatever. Like, this person, or even like just for a shopping spree to another city, like literally just for the day. But this, and then they like keep like, that fantasy goes on when they think about that, like having sex with you in another city, in, you know, just in that travel mode, anywhere that's not home, let's say it like that. I feel like this person is having vivid fantasy. Like, this person, this is an air card, so they're really good communicators, and they're also like thinking a lot, and I think thinking a lot about you. So maybe they really have these like scenarios in the head, like taking you there, and then, you know, like having sex with you somewhere that's not home, that's not your bed, that's not conventional. So that's was pretty spicy. I like this energy. But this person is not just interested in sleeping with you, because we have the Hierophant here, and this represents marriage, as I said. So this person could see themselves committing to you, talking to you on the daily, like building some kind of relationship, if it's friends with benefits, but they still take you as a person very, very seriously. And maybe they could actually see themselves with you in a committed, stable relationship. Whatever you guys prefer, but this person does not just think about sex with you. We have the heart chakra crystal here. So this person has already sparked some feelings for you. I mean, obviously, if you're already in a relationship with this person and this energy resonates with your partner, then of course they already have sparked that love for you inside of them. But if this is someone fairly new, as soon as they like got to talk to you or find out a little bit more about you, or maybe you're actually dating this person, yeah, like they have the feels. So I just shuffled the Sexual Magic Tarot deck and the Lovers came out. Beautiful. So the Lovers is the number 6 in the tarot, and this year, you know, 222 is 6, so 2022 equals 6. 6 is the number of love, 6 is the number of commitment. This person is all about you, and of course they fantasize about you sexually. So this could be a same-sex relationship. There might be two women here, or if you were talking about a masculine energy, this person might have thought about having a threesome with two women, or you know, whatever the scenario is, but and whatever the combination is, but this person has thought about a threesome before. Let's see, what does this person fantasize about, my viewer, my viewers? Oh, okay. Let's get some. Okay. Interesting. So the first card that came out is the Knave of Swords, and I love this card because I feel like your person is represented here by this guy. Again, even if they are a woman, I feel like they are really like down to their knees looking at you. And they're just wowed by you. Like, they are so fascinated by you. Maybe you have like really delicate curves, long hair, tiny perky boobies. Or if you're a guy, you might be very tall and slender and slim, but still like really gorgeous. Yes, this person thinks about you a lot. This is another element air card, the Knave of Swords. Then we have the Death card in the reverse. So I feel like this person fantasizes about you, that your relationship transforms in some sort of way. So whatever is going on right now, they want your relationship or whatever is going on, situationship, to transform to either a higher level, because we have the Hierophant here and the Lovers, to something more serious. Or maybe if you're in a long-term connection, maybe they want to like propose to you. They want to like transform something within this energy. I'm also getting, if this person that you're interested in has like a tough past, or has like someone they're currently kind of still with, they want to break up with that person and let them go. And if you're third wheeling, you guys, just know that this person wants you and they want to let go of their past. Or maybe this person hasn't been quite over their ex, so there's some kind of third party situation going on, that this doesn't mean that this person is cheating, this doesn't mean that this person is married or having another affair or another relationship. This could just mean that there has been someone on their mind and they're ready to let that go and to end that situation that they have been in. Then we have Temperance. So when they think about you sexually, I'm really getting the sense that they like to idolize you and put you on a pedestal. So this person is like turned on when they fantasize that you're like this beautiful woman or man that they have to kind of woo over. So they have to like put in the work and you're a little bit like, I don't know. They like when you're being a little bit held back and you're not really rushing into their energy. They like that they have to put in the work and kind of sex you up. And maybe they even fantasize about having a glass of wine or maybe white wine. Or red wine, doesn't matter, or just having some kind of beverage with you, maybe even playing with like fruits. Let's pick one more card and then I think I have to move over to the next group. Woo-hoo-hoo! We have the Six of Wands. So this person likes your booty, they like your booty. Don't comment down below, but I ain't got no booty. I don't like my booty. I don't care. This person likes your booty. And this is like, it doesn't matter if it's like round and juicy or it's like small and petite. This person really enjoys your curves. And again, this theme of like having sex outside in nature, in the grass, in the summertime, like having a picnic, some drinks, you know, some wine and just in nature, and you're like having sex in the wild. They also love dresses on you. So if you are a woman, they love to see you in dresses. They love to like see you like taking care of yourself and having like feminine clothes on. And if you're a guy, they like that you wear very like stylish clothes. But the emphasis is really on the naked body here, so they really like your body. I like this. And they like to see you naked, so maybe they fantasize about you naked a lot. If this person hasn't seen you naked yet, they like to fantasize about your naked physique, and they really like your body. And if they haven't, if they have seen you naked, they can't erase this picture anymore. Like, they have to think about it all the time. It just pops back into their head and they're like rethinking the situation when you were naked. This is really nice, but I'm definitely getting the vibe that this person has already sparked some feelings for you. So if this person's trying to like play it cool and they're like, yeah, I'm not even that interested, or you know, they're playing hard to get, this person already really really likes you, so that's really sweet. And I think about you a lot, especially having a good time with you. So I hope you guys enjoyed this kinky, quick, fiery reading. And I see you all in my next video. And don't forget to like and subscribe. Comment down below what kind of topics you would like to see on my channel. And I'll see you all next time. Hello, hello, my lovey-doveys. So if you chose the second crystal in the middle, the blue one, then this is your reading. So your person could be an air sign. They don't have to be. That's just what's coming up because I'm seeing this like blue. I mean, that could also be a water sign. Water or air, doesn't matter. Could be anywhere in the chart. So don't focus on that. I'm just trying to get into the energy. This person likes to talk. They might really love to talk about you, if you know it or not. Now you know. And I feel like this person wants you to be very verbal when you have sex with them, when you're doing sexy time, when you're having sexy time with them. So what does my viewer's person fantasize about them? We have the Queen of Cups. So this person might be very emotional. And they like to get in their feels. But they could also view you as this energy, as this Queen of Cups. Doesn't matter the gender, if you're a guy or a woman. They might see you as someone who's a provider. Someone who likes to take care of other people emotionally. You're a good listener and they love that about you because this person likes to talk. But we want to get that sexual energy. Okay, Nine of Pentacles. This person thinks you have such good energy. They really love to spend time with you. And we have the Lovers. So this person, they love everything about you. Your body, your voice, your aesthetic. They think you're sexy in every way because they feel like you're mama potential. So if you're a woman, they see you as wife material. They see you as a beautiful partner, someone they want to spoil with a lot of money. And they see you as a potential soulmate. So it doesn't matter the situation here, if this is a crush, a relationship, or someone you just thought about, just take it how it resonates. So they feel very divine with you. Like when they're naked in front of you or next to you, on top of you, down low, somewhere, this person feels very divine with you, even when it's getting steamy and sexual. And this person thinks about the emotional connection they have with you all the time. And I feel like this person wishes they could communicate that to you, but they're having a hard time because this crystal represents the throat chakra. So, yeah. And also, they love to talk dirty. They fantasize about you with your beautiful voice, talking dirty to them in bed. So what does my viewer's person fantasize about them? Ooh, they see you as the high priestess. I'm getting that you're a woman, you don't have to be. Apply this to your situation. But this person thinks you're everything. You are emotionally just so fulfilling. You're grounded, you're loving, you're wise. They think you're very smart and that really turns them on because you're like, you have quick wit. Like you can just tell this person to F off. And you can make this person wild in bed. If you know or not, but you can make this person wild in bed with how you talk, how you act. Just, I feel like this person views you as you are their perfect fit. This is beautiful. This is very beautiful. They like your breasts, so if you have breasts, they love your chest area. If you're a guy, you might have like a really nice chest. You might have brown eyes or some other eye color, it doesn't matter, but they get lost in your eyes. And especially when they fantasize about having really romantic sex with you, which is cute. But also like being dirty but loving at the same time. And they love to like fantasize, you know, this romantic sex, but looking into your eyes and you just losing it because they're so good. they just love to fantasize about that. And then they might really like your feet. Maybe you wear like bangles on your feet or toe rings or some kind of jewelry on your feet. They really, really love that. So they fantasize about that. And then you just have a really nice body, like really nice curves. The world just flew out. So they view you as someone of such a high value. I wouldn't be surprised if you're already with this person or this person has been in your life in the past. There's some kind of connection here or just a really deep connection with this person. So yeah, they think about you all the time, your hands, your feet, your waist, your arms, your cute smile, your moaning, how you talk in bed, your smell. They just like to caress you and like embrace you for this goddess or god that you are. And they love your jewelry. If you wear like a lot of like delicate jewelry, they think it's really cute. Yeah, beautiful. Sweet, this is so sweet. And even if this sounds boring to you guys, like this is like, oh, they're so like romantic and like, oh, they're so sweet, so sweet, so sweet. No, like they can get off when you're near like that. Like they think you're so special and they want to offer you something. Like they want to come forward and just offer you something. Like, I don't know if it's a commitment, a relationship. Maybe they want to give you something, like a gift. Maybe they know that you have like a very unique taste in something. Maybe it's like books or jewelry or some kind of hobby, and they want to make you a gift. And they're fantasizing about this situation where they could get in touch with you and talk to you. And then they're just like getting in their head about this and just going crazy, because it always ends in their mind, in their sexual fantasy, that they will have sex with you and it will be amazing and they will rock your world and you will be hooked to them. I feel like this person fantasizes a lot about you being just as hooked to them as they are to you. Maybe you don't even know this person thinks about you this way. And this is getting more intense. We have the Queen of Pentacles. This person down there is literally to her feet. They view you as this high priestess. You're their world. Like, you're the Queen of Pentacles to them. You might have like a really aristocrat face, like beautiful lips and very long sharp nose, something like, you know, like those old like Greek statues and drawings. You're royalty to this person and they just want to suck on your toes and get on their knees for you. This is sweet. I like this. This is really sweet. Okay, what does this person fantasize sexually? Let's get more into the topic. Oh my god. I don't know. We have the Ten of Swords. I feel like this person hurts themselves by fantasizing about you. Like, they get so steamy and so in their head. And you know when they fantasize, like, they're deep down in it, like, having sex with you. And then suddenly they get so frustrated because they realize that this is, at the end, a fantasy. And that you might already be with someone else. And then sometimes pictures of someone else having sex with you pops in their head. Or you just not choosing them. I don't know. This is like really intense. Like, they make themselves feel so down and so frustrated. And they hurt themselves with the way they fantasize about you. Like, on one hand, like, you're everything they want. But deep down, maybe this person thinks they don't deserve you, or you might already like, or you like someone else better than them. This is like deep insecurity that is coming up. And this person has a hard time expressing what they truly feel, what they truly want to tell you. So if you're already in a relationship with this person, they feel like they always have to work to keep you. Because you could just slip out of their fingers, which is not a bad thing, because you should always put in effort for your partner, it no matter how long you've been with this person. But this person takes it really far. they really beat themselves up with their insecurities in their head. It's like they're just having this dream fantasy with you, having sex, being all romantic, and just having this incredible individual by their side, and then they're just like crashing, and they're like, but I could never have this person. They're probably with someone else, or they're probably cheating on me and doing this, and they could have whoever. Who are you guys? Because this person, you're a god or goddess to this person. Like, you might be their soulmate, their divine partner. And it's just, they feel like it's too good to be true sometimes. But they have mad fantasies. Like, they think about you a lot. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment down below what you guys want to see next. And I hope this was short, sweet, kinky, and nice. And I'll see you all next time. Hello, my pile number threes. If you chose this orange brownish crystal, then this is your reading. You're in the last pile and they're still burning some sage. It's about to go out, so yeah. So this crystal represents the sacral chakra, which really fits with the topic today, because this is the chakra of your sexual energy, sexual desire, everything that's supposed to do with everything beneath the navel. So this person could be highly, highly sexual. They could have a high sex drive, or this could represent that they're blocked within their sexuality, but we're going to find out. This sounded very dramatic, but yeah, we'll see. Ooh, we have the sun. So what does this person fantasize when they think about you? They're happy. Whenever they think of you, they're super happy and they feel like a child. You could have like a really lighthearted connection with this person. Like, they get all smiley and they laugh a lot because they're just really happy to see you. And I don't know. You could have a child with this person. Or that you just really bring out that childish, lighthearted, trust energy. We have the Queen of Swords. So this person respects you, but you also make them very, very horny. And there might be a dynamic here that someone is dominating the other. They could be dominating you, or they like to be dominated by you. So either way, that's really kinky and I like it. Let's see what else is coming up in this reading. What does your person fantasize about you? Stay tuned. We have the Fool. So this connection might be quite new to you, or if you have been with this person or have known this person for quite some time, then there's something about your dynamic that has changed and that has sparked something new. Or like, maybe you've been trying new positions, new kissing techniques, just something new. Like, maybe you've been starting to incorporate sex toys, some, or food or drinks or whatever. Something new has sparked this person and they cannot stop thinking about you. They get very naive and like lost in thought when they think about you. That you make this person so like childish. I love it. Maybe you are an authority person for this particular person. Maybe you are their boss or their colleague and they really look up to you. Or maybe they like to fantasize about you being in a higher position than them and you're getting all steamy and sexual at work or somewhere where it's like not normal to have sex with your partner or with your fling or lover. Huh. Ooh, we have the King of Wands. They love to like, I can't quite pinpoint which, whose energy is this, because you have to just apply to your situation. What I'm describing could be your energy or their energy. I have a hard time right now to differ. So this person loves to like caress you and take care of you and be strong, but they love that you pick up this person. And again, these readings are not about gender, so just apply it to your situation and whatever your preferences are. But this person feels really safe with you, and I feel like this person really can let down their guard with you. Like, they can make themselves feel vulnerable even while having sex with you. Like, they don't need to be this strong, independent person. They can let their guard down. They can be a little bit more devo. Is it devo? Dominant and devo. Maybe there is some kind of dynamic here. They fantasize of you taking the lead, I feel like. And they fantasize about getting you pregnant. Someone getting pregnant here. That's making them feel really hot, like them putting their seeds in you. Or just making you pregnant. Even if this is a same-sex situation, they could still fantasize about that. We have the Eight of Wands. I feel like this person fantasizes of being alone with you, and suddenly someone is like spying on you, seeing you guys, and like it turns them on, turns you on, turns the person watching on. Maybe doing it outside where people might see you guys together, steamy, sexy. We have the Sun again. So this might already be your partner or someone you have like a very happy time with right now. Or this person sees themselves super duper happy with you. This is really cute. They love being naked with you. They fantasize about you just in their arm, in their arms. Sometimes they think about doing it outside, like the sun is going down and you're just on the grass, like some wild animals. We have the Seven of Cups. So this person knows that you have a lot of options. Or maybe they have a lot of options, but you are always their first choice. Like, if they have never told you, like, you're the apple of their eye, and there's no one they like having sex with more than with you. So sometimes they replay in their head how the sex was with you. And if this is someone you haven't had sex with yet, then I fantasize about it a lot, and you make this person very, very happy. But I do feel like for this reading, this might be a couple's reading, because like these people are super intertwined and all together, and yeah. Or this might be a past person that you've been in a connection with, and this like energy is just reliving, and that's why the Fool is here. So apply it to your situation, take it how it resonates. There are multiple scenarios for multiple people out there, because there's multiple people watching. So just apply it to your situation and you will know what resonates with you. So they like to fantasize like having dates with you, taking you out on a date, and then all of a sudden, like, it's been like super, like, everybody's like pulling themselves together, you're just having dinner, and then all of a sudden it turns into this wild, sexy situation, and they love for you to give them head. So they love your mouth and your tongue, and even like what you do with your hands. And they like that you can fully let go, or at least in their fantasy, you're totally letting go. Like, you don't care how you look, you don't care what you're doing, you're just so focused on what's going on with the two of you, and it feels so close. Feels very, very close. And you are deeply, deeply, like, you trigger their sacral chakra, so like, you could have not talked for years and years, and they see you again, and it's just like this energy that's coming back, like, remember me? We have amazing, this is like, you guys have amazing sex. If you've had sex together, this person replays it in their mind. They love having oral sex with you. They love kissing you. They think about kissing you a lot. They think about hugging you. And having also, like, talking to you deeply after sex. So, and the thought of you, and the thought of you naked is just making them so happy. And that's why this is so, so beautiful. And we have the sun here twice, and then this little, like, chakra sign also looks like a sun. This is just very beautiful. Let's pick another card, because this person is just really fulfilled. They really see their happiness with you. Also in bed, there's no one that knows like the twists and turns and the desires this person has. You fulfill them all, and they know that when, like, if they were to get with someone else, like, it would be so hard to find this kind of connection with someone else. They know that, and they don't want this flame or the sun to ever die out. And as far as I can see, that ain't happening. We have the magician. So you might have manifested each other. You're really what you want in a person. And that's so freaking important, to know what you want, to attract it, and then to truly be very, very grateful for you, for what you have. And when you always, like, tell the universe how grateful for you are for what you already have, it will always be protected, that special connection. Because if you're just like getting used to each other, and you're like, oh yeah, well, I have a relationship, yeah, I'm pretty happy, and you're not really like that grateful, like, gratitude, man, it's so important. And I feel like this person is really, really grateful for you. And if you're not with this person anymore, then maybe this person's really manifesting you back, or there's some kind of new cycle, new energy coming in. But for the most of you guys, I feel like you're already with this person, or dating this person, or you're friends with this person, and this person, you make this person so happy, and they could really, really, really see themselves in a committed relationship with you. Like, these cards, like, they could see themselves, if that's something they would want, they can see themselves have kids with you, marrying you, having sex with you for the rest of their lives, because you're everything. Like, you are their desire, and you're all they're thinking about. Your naked body, how you feel, how they touch you, how you touch them, what you do with your mouth, with your hands, how you smell, how you move, how you caress this person. I like it. This was very, very beautiful. I hope you enjoyed this reading, guys. If you did, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, comment down below, and subscribe. And I see you all next time. And have a lovely day, lovely night, lovely evening, wherever you are in the world. and I see you all next time.